for. Well, mental health blogging has taken off in recent years, and today's afternoon play is based on one of the most popular. Do's and Don'ts for the Mentally Interesting by Louise Ramsden, based on the blog The Secret Life of a Manic Depressive by Séainin Molloy.
You still wake up, don't you? Wake up with the lamb screaming. Do you think if you call Buffalo Bill, you can make the lamb stop screaming? No! No! Stop! Séainin. S-E-A-N-E-E-N. S-E-A-C. S-E-A-S-I-D-E. Seaside. Séainin. S-E-A-N-E-E-N. Seaside. One plus one is two. Two plus two is four. 3 plus 3 is 6. 4 plus 4 is 8.
All right, sweetheart.
Rob, it's me.
Of course it's you. What's the matter?
Can you come home? I think I've gone insane.
Listening to Mazzy Star always reminds me of my time in St. Gregory's Hospital. The night before my assessment, I listened to them on repeat, hoping they would calm me. But I skipped song after song. I simply couldn't concentrate.
Séainin.
At about 5 in the morning,
Séainin.
I had shut the door and was doing star jumps.
Séainin.
Shouting my own name over Séainin. And over again to rid myself of energy. Séainin. Visiting was tough and I didn't really allow my friends to come. Rob did, however.
I've won.
You have not?
1, 2, 3, 4.
Sorry. Can't concentrate. Play again.
Neen. Did I do the right thing, bringing you here?
Come on, best of three. Here we go.
My ward was the acute ward, designed to care for those in the midst of episodes. There were schizophrenics suffering from catatonia and psychosis, and there were self-harming depressives. I felt like I didn't belong there and wondered, who were these crazy people and why was I with them?
You have bipolar disorder, type 1,
said my psychiatrist.
Manic depression. Don't be ridiculous.
The clinical term we use is bipolar disorder. It's a severe mental illness characterised by extreme swings of mood, highs and lows, thought to be caused by a mixture of genetics, chemical imbalance and stressful life events.
You've got it wrong. I'm fine. Look at me.
You're very manic at the moment. You said you were hearing music.
I've just had a lot of coffee.
You were repeating lines from Silence of the Lambs?
So? It's marvellous.
You've had hallucinations, and your speech is what we call pressured.
I always talk fast. I'm Irish, for God's sake.
Séainin, you said your thoughts were racing.
You're all overreacting.
So much so, you cut yourself to try and release the pressure. Look, we'll meet the crisis team shortly and we'll talk together about what your treatment will involve. I understand you're already seeing a counsellor to talk about issues around your dad, is that right?
I just want to go home, please.
The crisis team will decide whether you're okay to leave. Is there anything you wanted to ask in the meantime?
Can my boyfriend come in?
The crisis team believed I was at risk to myself and it took some cajoling from Rob before they were eased. Rob promised them that he would take some time off work to look after me on my discharge from hospital. So, I returned home and began the process of accepting and managing my illness. Armed with lithium, I believed a whole new and healthy life would be blossoming before me. I later found out it wasn't that easy. This month, I decided to start an online blog detailing the true day-to-day life of a manic depressive and the challenges I faced, including getting the help I needed, dealing with medication, coming to terms with...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.